Hi guys, welcome to Code Bashers. Today's video is about important Python interview questions. So many of you have asked me to make the important interview questions of Python. So here I am with the video. So this video is divided into two sections. First of all, I will be discussing in first section, I will be discussing about the theoretical questions on Python. And in next section, I will be discussing upon the conceptual questions which are asked in the interview from Python only. So before starting the video, please guys like this video and subscribe to my channel, and now let's just get start with the video. So the questions are, so first question that is very common is, what are the applications of Python? So guys, you know that the Python is widely used in AI and ML projects, and Python can also be used in the web development site also. Next question is, what is typecasting in Python and how can we do it? So the typecasting means changing one data type into another. So you can explain this to the interviewer, and you can also give the example as like int and brackets input. So by this syntax, by this method, typecasting is done in Python. So input is a string variable, and when it is typecast into the int, it gets converted into integer. So the next question is, explain list in Python. So those of you who know Python, they must have encountered list somewhere or the other. So lists are the most important data type in Python. In every interview, you will get a question like which will be based on the list only. So explain list in Python. So list is the built-in data type in Python which are used to store various items in a single variable. So this is a very confined and detailed explanation of list in Python. Now next question, which is most commonly asked, is what is the difference between list and arrays in Python? So as if you encounter an interview in which Python questions are being asked, so this question is the most important question in the Python. It will be 100% asked by you. So you should know the difference between list and arrays in Python. So arrays, they are fast, like computationally they are fast. And arrays, they contains element of same data type in a single array. For example, if you make an array of int type, then all the elements which are present in that array will be of data type int. But whereas in list, what happens? Lists are slow in nature. And second difference is that doing math operation takes time in list as compared to arrays. So arrays are fast and they can do math operation very easily. Next difference is that the elements in a single list can be of different data types. Like the list can contain integer as well as a string data type in a single go. So the next question is, what are tuples in Python? So you have heard the term of a tuple in Python. So it is also very frequently asked in the Python interview. So you can simply say that tuple is a collection of elements and it is unchangeable. Unchangeable means that the elements in a tuple can't be removed, they can't be updated, and the elements cannot be inserted once a tuple is formed. So these are some of the questions which I am discussing, and they are very frequently asked in the interview. The next question is, what is the difference between the list and a tuple in Python? So as I told you earlier, that difference between list and arrays is the most important question in Python. Similarly, difference between list and tuple is also very important question. So you must by heart this difference. So the difference is that in list, update, insert and delete options are present in list. And whereas in tuple, the delete, update and insert options are not present. In lists are slow and tuple are fast as compared to the list. So next question is, explain the continue and break statement in Python. So this must be a very basic question, but it is very frequently asked in the interview. So what does a continue statement does? It skips a particular iteration. And what does a break statement does? It breaks through the loop. Now the next question is, what does a map keyword do in Python? So this is also a very important and frequently asked question in an interview. So to read about the map keyword, I will give you the link in the description. You can check out there. So in Python till now, we have studied about the theoretical as well as the keywords. So keywords are also very important part of the interview of Python. The next question is, what are the lambda functions and why are they used? So the lambda functions are one linear functions which compute a specific expression at a time. And if you want to read lambda functions in detail, I will again give you the link in the description only. You can check that out. The next question is, explain is alpha and is name functions. So a Python interviewer will definitely ask you one of these two functions at a time. So you should know what does this function do. So again, I will give you the link in the description so that you can read about these functions. The next question is also very important. That is, what is the difference between a append keyword and what is the difference between a extend keyword? So what is the difference in between these two? So what does append keyword do? It is used to add one element to the list, end of the list. And what does a extend function do? It is used to add multiple elements to the list. So this is the difference between these two keywords. So you should be knowing the difference because this question is also frequently asked in the interview, and it is also an important question. So the next question is Python a case sensitive language? So yes, Python is a case sensitive language, just as Java as well as C++. So Python is also a case sensitive language. So these were the questions. These were the 12 questions which I found out that were frequently being asked in the interview. And these were the theoretical questions which were asked from the Python. Now let's look at the conceptual questions which are asked in the Python interview. So first conceptual question is, what will be the output of cat into 3? So what does it does? It simply concatenate the string 3 times. So it is a operation of string multiplication. That is, a string is multiplied by the variable. So here cat into 3 becomes 3 times cat appended to each other. Next question is, what will be the output of first list, that is 1, 2, 3, and the second list, that is 4, 5, 6. It means that two lists are getting added. So what does a plus operator will do? It will concatenate these two strings. Oh, these two lists. Many of you get confused in the interview. You just simply add this element by this element, but it is a wrong in case of Python. So what does plus operator do? It concatenates the two lists. So you can see that the output will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the next question is, s is a string which contains a string of string name string. So they will ask you, is s0 is equal to f possible? So no, it is not possible because string in Python are immutable. That is, once a value is allocated, the value can't be changed. So here the value of a character at a particular index can't be changed after a string is formed. So this is also the answer will be false, that it is not possible. Next question is, if s is given as from and we perform an operation, that is s dot lower, what s dot lower does? It lower downs the all the values from this string. So after s dot lower, we will simply print s. So what will be the output? So the real output will be the same string as it is, but many of you answer it as from, but it will be a wrong answer. It will be a right answer when this expression is given, like s is equal to s dot lower. So when this expression is given, then the string will get into lower form, but when this equal to expression is not given, then the string will remain as it is. So it will be from only in caps lock. So these were the four questions. The next question is that s is given as string. Now we have to perform string compressions on it. So what will be the output of this? That is, s is equal to string and s is given as this. So we have to output this expression. So it will be simply, it will reverse the string. So our string will be reversed. So when we will read it from behind, it will be string only. So these were the 5 conceptual questions which we discussed and are very commonly asked in the interview. So as this was the entire video, I hope you like this video. Please comment down if you want more such important questions of more subjects. Like in this video, I have discussed Python. If you want machine learning, you can write down in the comment section, or OS or DBMS. So please like this video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.